Cincinnati Academy of Physical Education, the Ironton Fighting Tigers. Battle of unbeatens, battle of number one and number two. The Cape Crusaders, a record of 8-0. The co-captains for both ball clubs are meeting at midfield. It's Vincent Clark and Lark Dudley for the Cincinnati Academy of Physical Education. For the Ironton Fighting Tigers, Mike Southers and A.J. Edwards. Ironton in their home black jerseys, the orange helmets, the white numerals, Cape in white jerseys, red numerals with navy blue pants and navy blue helmets. And now the Cape Crusaders, led by Carlos Snow, coming to the near side here, the visitor side, to the applause of their fans who've made the trip of some 2.5, 3 hours from Cincinnati to follow their ball club. For Cape, on offense, we look for him something like this tonight. At left end, Marcus Wilkins, 6'4", 200-pound senior. At left tackle, Troy Parker, 5'9", 220 pounds, and a senior. At left guard, Alonzo Perdue, 5'11", 178 pounds, and a junior. The center, Lark Dudley, 5'10", 185 pounds, Dudley a senior. The right guard, LaDon Bailey, 5'10", 197 pounds, a sophomore. The right tackle, Billy Philpott, 6'3", 215 pounds, and a senior. There were much ballyhooed, Carlos Snow. Carlos at 5'9", 200 pounds. He is a senior. The toss of the coin has been conducted at midfield. The Ironton Fighting Tigers will be kicking off to start this game, kicking to the Cincinnati Academy of Physical Education. Let's check the Ironton defensive unit for you. At left defensive end, we'll see Mike Southers, one of the co-captains, as we mentioned. Mike, 6'3", 215 pounds, and a senior. His running mate at left defensive tackle, Kelvin Ford, 6 foot, 195 pounds, and a junior. The nose guard will be John Turner. John, 5'9", 180 pounds, and a junior. The right defensive tackle, Matt Thomas. Matt at 5'10", 195 pounds. He is a junior. The right defensive end will be Barry Carney. Barry, 5'11", 180 pounds, and a junior. Tigers coming out of their locker room to the roar of this big, big crowd here at Tank Stadium. And Charlie Spencer and Mark Stamp will burst through the hoop and are followed by the rest of the Fighting Tigers. The linebackers for tonight, the aforementioned Charlie Spencer. Charlie, 6 foot, 185 pounds, and a senior. The other linebacker, John Thompson. John, 5'11", 185 pounds. He is a junior. The cornerbacks, James Lewis, 5'7", 155 pounds, a senior. The other cornerback on the right side, Billy Jackson. Billy, 5'10", 170 pounds, and a senior. The safeties, A.J. Edwards. A.J. at 6 foot, 175 pounds, a senior. The other safety, Joe Young. Joe at 5'8", 140 pounds. He is a junior. The Ironton Fighting Tiger defense, as a unit, their first team has surrendered, I think, only 32 points. Some 14 other points have been accounted against the Ironton reserves in ball games that they've had well in hand towards the end of the conclusion. They've got a big task, not only taking on Carlos Snow, but taking on an offensive unit in Cincinnati Academy of Physical Education. Steve is averaging 47 points a game. Not only Carlos Snow, but Bryant and Lee and Clark, they provide some explosive power out of their back through.
Exactly. I think that also, Rick, and I talked to Coach Terry Parker and Pat Sheridan before the game. I was here about 5:30. People were just starting to fill in. They opened the gate at 6. And they said that the victory for the Tigers lies within the offensive and defensive line. Offensive line done exceptionally well this year. This is the first time this year they have faced an offensive line smaller than them, but just as quick, if not quicker. If they say they can get A.J. Edwards enough time to pass the ball or his quarterback keepers up the middle, then the Tigers have a very good chance of winning. We'll see. It's going to be a great, great, great football game. Nice to have you with us. We'll be talking about Carlos Snow. We put him in the same category as a Herschel Walker, Eric Dickerson, Mark Higson from Lexington. Of course, he's playing for you at the University of Kentucky. Carlos Snow has scored more touchdowns than any player in the history of high school football. 95. Eric Dickerson with the Rams. Of course, Herschel Walker now at the Dallas Cowboys. That puts you in the same class as he is. A little smaller back, but a good one. The Ironton defense has played tough all year long. Ironton's kicking off. I think this was pre-planned. I think Ironton decided to kick off because they want to see just how they can handle this team offense. It's a good one. And here to paint the word picture from Ironton Tank Stadium. And I need to tell you, it is a full house, probably more than a Boyd County game, is my broadcast buddy, Rick Charles.
Thank you. As this long-awaited battle is about to unfold. Your officials tonight, the referee Alan Bass, the umpire Jim Klotzenberg, the head linesman Bob Ackerman, the field judge John Boyd, and the back judge Clark Collins. Both teams awaiting this opening kickoff. Billy Jackson, the release man, is back along the line now. Here is the approach, and number one meeting number two is underway. Here is the kick, and it's taken by Mathis at his five. He's to the 10, to the 15, the 20, got some room to run, puts the head down, and Jimmy DePriest drives him down at about the 29-yard line. Good kick coverage downfield, but a fine return of 24 yards. Cape has the football first and 10 from their 24-yard line. The eye. Lee under center. Looking to throw on first down. Puts the ball up and it is incomplete. And Lee took a pretty good pop from the Ironton rush. The pass intended for Marcus Wilkins, and the Ironton defense up to the task, at least here on first down.
Good pressure for the Ironton line. This time the Ironton line wins the battle of the line of scrimmage, and Lee was rushed considerably that time.
Second down and 10. Wilkins flanked far to the left. Clark in the slot. Darnell Lee. Snow handling the football. First time he's hit, he's across the 30 to about the 34. Billy Jackson and John Thompson involved in the hit for Ironton. And the crowd buzzing with the anticipated first carry of the evening by Carlos Snow. He picks up four. It's third down and center. Center on the third down play. Optioning, left side. Here's the pitch. Snow turning the corner. He's hemmed in. Still surging forward. Snow down the sideline, and he's into Ironton territory. Down at about the Tiger 47. He's got more than enough for the first down. To the great speed of Carlos Snow. Turning the corner left side. He's finally ridden out of bounds on the far side. Well, now they're marking it back right at midfield, so he didn't quite make it into Ironton territory. Slot left. From the eye on first and 10. Lee. Bryant hit pretty hard. He's still driving. Bryant driving down to about the Ironton 45. The big crowd roaring again. Gary Carney and Joe Young there defensively for the Fighting Tiger defense. Second down and 5 from the 45. Lee pitching. Snow the football. Snow coming to the outside, and he's hit the fine defensive play. Tommy Spencer coming up to drop Carlos Snow for about a 2-yard, maybe a 3-yard loss. Again, the crowd comes to life as it was mano a mano there.
Great play by Charlie Spencer.
Wilkins to the far side is a wide out. Clark in the slot on third down and 7, a long 7. Lee wants to throw. He's got the ball up. The pass out there caught on the far side by Clark, and he would appear to have the first down as he made the reception apparently inside the 40. They're marking it about the 38. That'll be a first down for Cape. Line of scrimmage will be the 38. Cape still working with the opening kickoff. As the clock showing 9:45 to play in the first period. Slot left. Lee under center. Bobbles the football. Here's the pitch left side. Carlos Snow trying to move out of the traffic around the 35 and ridden out of bounds. A poor exchange between the quarterback and the center, and Lee is kind of shaking his hand a little bit like he either wasn't expecting the ball to come back that hard. The Ironton 34-yard line. Darnell Lee under center at quarterback. Slot right this time. Oh, there's a fine hit, and it looks like Ironton recovered the football. Yes. Matt Thomas laying a lick, just like you said, Steve. They drilled Lee. And Matt Thomas not only makes the hit, but he comes up with the football, the first turnover of the ball game. The Fighting Tigers get the ball in their own territory at the 38. Mark at the 36, following the hit and fumble recovery by Matt Thomas.
Great play by the Ironton defense as the defense, the nose guard for the Tigers, came through. I tell you what, that's a big play. John Thompson made a nice play, and John Turner and Matt Thomas picked it up. It's first down and 10, and a break for the Ironton Tigers. Do need to see what happens now.
A.J. Edwards, the Tiger quarterback. They keep it on the ground. James Lewis, nice shot across the 40 to about the 43-yard line before he's brought down. Let's check that Ironton offense for you. It's Thompson at center. Ford and Stamper, the guards. Southers and Thomas, the tackles. We'll also see McClellan and Brown in there. Carney and Young, the ends. Of course, Bobby Bryson, Billy Jackson also will see action there. Young coming out now. Carney in. The quarterback, Edwards. His fullback, Archie Malone. Spencer and Lewis, the halfbacks. The Ironton offense. And they've got a second down and 3 from their own 43-yard line. Cape fumbling the football away at the Ironton 36. We've got movement on the left side of the Ironton line, and that'll cost them 5, their first penalty of the game. Moves Ironton back 5 yards, so they make it now second down and 8. Line of scrimmage now, the 37. Edwards rolling right side. A.J. across the 40, staggers out of bounds around the 45. that's close to first down yardage, but he's still about a yard short. It'll be third down short yardage. Not among those starters is a 200-pounder. Check the rest of them in a minute. Full house backfield on third down and one for Ironton for their own 45. Charlie Malone spinning ahead for the first down. Archie Malone down at about the 48-yard line. That's 2 yards, good enough for the first down.
Once again, the line of scrimmage is being won this early part of the first quarter by the Ironton Tigers. Malone had a huge hole off the right side, and it's first down at 10. The Tigers' first down of the count.
Spencer, the Tiger backfield. It's the straight tee behind Edwards, the quarterback. Motion on the right side. Tackle came up out of his position, and that'll be a 5-yard step off against Ironton. Backfield combination of Malone, Spencer, and Lewis behind Edwards. Lewis gets the call. James back to the 45 and down. Quick closing Cape defense, shutting him down. And coming up there quickly to make this stop is Steve Jordan. Jordan, one of the linebackers, will finish the lineup here for you. Jordan, the linebacker. Locke Dudley, the leading tackler, the linebacker. And the left cornerback, Ricky Reed, the right cornerback, Darnell Lee, and the safety is Vincent Clark. And it was the opinion of the Ironton coaching staff that Clark was one of the more intimidating ball players on the Cape defense from what they'd seen in films and what they're aware of his capabilities. He's playing the center field home run position at safety for Cape. Penalty flags on this second down play from the 45. Penalty would appear to be against Cape tonight, albeit by virtue of the penalty. Edwards keeping it on the ground. James Lewis, the 45, the 40, bouncing off tackles, the 35, down to about the 34. James Lewis, the Tiger scat back. Up 15 yards. And another Tiger first down. Lewis, Malone, Spencer behind Edwards, the quarterback. Keep it on the ground. Archie Malone takes a pretty good hit right at about the line of scrimmage. Jordan coming up quickly from the lineback slot to hit him. Also getting a piece of him was Vincent Gates. Second down play. A.J. looking to throw, just as we say. Now it's the quarterback draw. The 35, still moving, and on the far sideline is down at about the 32-yard line. The Fighting Tigers, number two. And they're having at it here this evening in a long-anticipated football game. Slot right on third down. Edwards, the long count. James Lewis takes the handoff. He's dropped short of first down yardage. He's down to about the 27.
Tigers break huddle. Here we go. Big play. First quarter.
Four down territory, and if he's on that fourth down, the Tigers going for it from the 27. James Lewis diving ahead would appear to have the first down. The crowd seems to think so. The Cape defenders seem to think they've stopped him. We'll have the sticks brought out across the field. Nope, don't need it. They're already indicating that Cape has stopped him short of the first down. Needed to really get inside, I guess, the 25 to make dead sure of it. And Lewis on the dive over his center was stopped at the 25. Ironton back on defense. Clark is split wide to the left on first and 10 for the Crusaders from the 25. Carlos Snow taking a handoff. Carlos trying to break tackles, and he's out across the 30 to about the 32. Barry Carney and John Thompson combining for the defensive play for Ironton. And an overflow crowd here at Tanks Memorial Stadium. Clark again flanked to the left. And second and two. Lee looking to throw. Quick hitter. Man can't make the reception. He's open, but he dropped the football at his own 45. Edwin Houston, the intended receiver. The football is still laying exactly where he dropped it. Houston was open, but he just simply hit him in the wrong place, and he dropped it. Man just now getting in there and set. Lee taking the snap. He's hit and dropped it. A big defensive play again. McClellan and Brown, the two guys that just came into the game, not taking a fake at all by Lee. As he makes a little quick jerk when he comes out from under center, as if pitching the football, and then was bootlegging at the left side, or at least optioning, and he's hit, and it looks like his hand is hurting him again. So Lee is out of the game on the fourth down, and we'll see Cape punt the football away. Lewis and Bryce are deep for Ironton, standing back at their 35. Michael Bryant will tow the football on the punt for Cape. Here's the snap. It's a clean exchange and a kick. A fine punt. Bryant Booming kick and a mix-up between Bryce and Edwards, or Lewis. Now Bryce on the run with the football. Bobby in traffic, moving ahead, and he really made something out of what could have been a negative play for Anthony. Fielded the football at about his 24 after it bounded between he and James Lewis.
That's it for the Tigers.
Edwards under center. On the ground, James Lewis. James. Up the gut. He's across the 30 to maybe the 31. And a 9 for Ironton from there. 31 missed the Tigers' second possession of the ball game. We're inside the 2-minute mark of period number one, and we have no score. A.J. Edwards looking to throw. The rush is on. The pass is out intended for Malone, and he didn't look until too late. Coverage provided there on Malone by Melvin Ellis. And pass play. Barry Carney bringing this play in from the bench. Joe Young will come out of there. So it'll be Carney and Bryce, the tight ends. Spencer, Malone, and Lewis remain in the backfield, along with A.J. Edwards, the Tiger quarterback. Third down and 9, the Tiger 31. Ironton the football, rush on, Edwards trying to get away, penalty flags. Edwards wrestled down back at about his 22, and we've got penalty flags back at about the 25. So Edwards taken down by Bailey, Ladon Bailey. It was a motion penalty against the Fighting Tigers, declined by the Cape defense. We'll have to see Ironton punt the football away. Charlie down on one weak knee right now, tying his shoelaces. We got a timeout. Timeout on the field. A minute 42 to play first period. It's Ironton nothing, Cape nothing. Spencer awaiting the snap from Mark Lutz. Mark again at midfield awaiting that kick. Here's the snap. And the kick by Spencer. It's a boomer. Charlie blasting the ball down at about the 35 where Clark takes it. Clark on the run with the football, running laterally with it. He's in trouble, under pursuit by the Ironton kick coverage team, and Bryce wrestles him down. He gave up 15 yards trying to run away from the Ironton kick coverage. And Bryce got some help from Stamper and wrestled Vincent Clark down back at about his 16-yard line, and Clark just kept giving up the yardage, giving Ironton more time to get down there than any minute.
He kept giving up the yardage, and the credit Bobby Bryce for just staying right with him. Bryce was an animal going down there, and Bryce used his speed to get Clark, and really, he lost some 15-some yards on the play.
So Darnell Lee, the Cape quarterback, who went out of the last year, he's kind of shaking his right hand as if it was trembling. He's still kind of shaking as they come in on first and 10 from their own 16. Lee. Rolling this way, Snow in the open field. Jackson with him, puts a stiff arm on Jackson. Snow driven out of bounds by Edwards at about the 27-yard line. Boy, an indication of the strength of Carlos Snow. He put out the stiff arm and shucked Billy Jackson trying to make the tackle. Line of scrimmage now, the Cape 26-yard line. So he just did get 10 yards. Darnell Lee at quarterback with Clark in the slot. Lee optioning left side. He's going to keep it. Turns it upfield. Lee bouncing off tacklers. Now they swarm on him and drop him at about the 30. So pick up a 4 is Lee sweeping left. Cut it back against the grain. It came back towards the center of the field. And the Ironton defense reversed its gears in time and covered him after a 4-yard pickup by Lee. Clark to the near side this time as a wide out. Lee keeping it on the ground. Bryant, the ball carrier, he's down at about the 35. That's close to a first down, probably about a yard short. 2-1. That's it. They let time expire after one period of play here. The Tanks Memorial Stadium, our score, Ironton nothing. Take the football and third down in the yard from their 35. Ahead with it is close. Throw into the secondary, and he's down into Ironton territory just across midfield as James Lewis makes perhaps at this point a saving tackle. Tiger 49. Darnell Lee, quarterback. Bryant, the carry. Kicks up a cloud of dust, but I don't think he got the proverbial 3 yards. Maybe 2. Kelvin Ford and Thompson involved in the stop. Snow the tailback, Bryant the fullback. Lee under center at quarterback on 2nd and 9. Optioning, now the pitch, pass across the middle. With the football, Clark, and he just simply runs away from the Ironton secondary. Vincent Clark. The reception, and it's a 48-yard pass and run play for the touchdown, coming with 11:04 to play in the first half. Cape cracks the scoreboard first, and they lead it 6-0. McFadden on for the extra point placement kick. Here's the spot, but we've got penalty flags before the kick can be gotten off. And a penalty, apparently against Ironton, will be offside variety. That'll make it half the distance, I suppose. Across the crossbar. 11:04 to play, first half. It's Cape 7. The Ironton Fighting Tigers, nothing. Has just returned the kickoff from Cape all the way down to the Cape 43. Threw to the football at about his 7. Came all the way across field with it to the near hash mark side. Gets it back to the 43, so that's about a 50-yard kick return by Bobby Bryce, the junior halfback and tight end for the Fighting Tigers. And Ironton has it 1st and 10, trailing 7-0 here early in the second quarter. Edwards at quarterback, he's under center. Crowd buzzing after the big play. Lewis, the first down carry, and he's wrapped up right at about the line of scrimmage. And those here in the press box, and they don't really credit James with too much of a gainer, though the ball marker moving the football 75 yards.
In 6 plays, right. Capped by a 48-yard pass from Lee to Clark for the touchdown.
Edwards on 2nd down. He's looking to throw. He's under pressure, trying to get away. He's wrapped up and hit at midfield. Making the stop there is Vincent Gates. Midfield. Spencer flanked to the near side. Young to the far side. A.J. looking to throw. He's got time. They're going to throw it out in the flat. Arching along the football in traffic. He's hit and popped pretty good as he got into Cape territory at about the 48. So Archie took a pretty good pop. He's a little slow getting up. Back at about his 38 to kick the football away. Clark, the man who scored Cape's touchdown and a 48-yard pass play, is back to receive the kick. Here's the boot. It's a high one. Fair catch signal for by Clark. The ball bouncing and rolling towards the Cape goal. Billy Jackson lets it roll, and he downs it around the 5-yard line. So Cape been deep in their territory on this possession. Advantage right now at 7-0. Darnell Lee, the quarterback, calling the signals. He's handing off. Carlos Snow the football. Carlos trying to break the tackles, and he does all the way out to the 16-yard line before Young can bring him down. Quick hitting Carlos Snow, slashing out along behind the left side of his offensive line, picking up the 1st down. 98 of them, I think it is, all told. When you've been holding to a 1st down, it is a measure of success for you defensively. Snow in motion to the right side. There's something different. Up the middle, Bryant, wrapped up by Southers, dropped at about the 18. In this ball game tonight, ourselves, of course, Jim Walker is regular beat the Ironton Tribune. And Herald Dispatch, the Daily Independent from Ashland, represented here. Cincinnati radio station, we understand, is doing some live feeds back to the Cincinnati area on the ball game. 2nd down carry. Snow the football. He's hit at about the 20. Got crossed away to the 21. Down and 5. This is a big defensive play for the Fighting Tigers. If they can contain the Cape Crusaders here and force the punt, get the football back, they'll take a little of the edge off the Cape Crusaders, who lead in the football contest and are riding high on the emotion of that right now. Reverse. Clark, left side. He's pinned in. Oh, fine hit from behind. We've got a penalty flag. right at about the vicinity of the hit, back at about the 22. Clark fell forward to about the 25. That's still short of first down yard. He's actually the 26. Clip against Kate. Whoever made the tackle also got leveled, I think, on the hit. On the clip, that is, and they fell forward and made the hit on Clark. That may have been a break for the Fighting Tigers because the man clipped falling forward doesn't make that contact, and Clark maybe has a little more room to work with. But when the Tiger defense had him come in, Clark goes to the near sideline after that play and is going to the bench. Clock rolling again. We're inside 7 minutes to play in the first half. 7-0, Cape on top of the Ironton Fighting Tigers. Here's a quick kick by Cape. Football rolling. It's rolling and coming to rest back at the Ironton 30. A fine call by Steve Sheehan. And on the kick, 59 yards.
Yeah, we'll see what happens. Here's Rick Charles.
Edwards bringing his team out on first and 10 for Ironton from their 30. A.J. keeping on the ground. James Lewis ahead, and just as he crossed the 30, takes a pretty good lick. In addition to being quick, the Crusaders will put the shoulder to you. And so far, a highly entertaining football game. Spencer comes to the near side as a wideout on the second and eight. From the Tiger 32, Carney is flanked to the far side. Whistles and penalty flags now, just before the snap of the football. And the penalty apparently will go against the Crusader defense. Offside, the initial indication. Here's the step off. Ball game. Being tested here. Malone didn't carry. Edwards on the carry. AJ to about the 40. It'll be third down and short yardage from there. Take carried out very well by Archie Malone. Fooled a portion of the Cape defense, and Edwards slithering his way upfield. Moves the football to the Tiger 40. It's third down and about a half yard. Carney out, Young in. And yet another big play coming up. Tops in the center, he's out over the football. Crowd coming to life once again. James Lewis has the first down as he hurls forward almost to the 45-yard line. They'll mark it at the 44 for Ironton. And a first down for the Fighting Tigers. They hang on to the football. Straight ahead with James Lewis.
Three first downs for the Ironton Tigers, and really, I'm sure Coach Brooks breathing a sigh of relief over there. When Lewis went for the extra yardage, he almost fumbled the football when he hit the ground.
Spencer, wing back to the right. Malone and Lewis, the setbacks. Edwards bobbling the football. He dives and falls back on it. Never really had a good handle on it. And taking the snap was okay, but on his way to drop back the pass, he bobbled the football just a bit. Ironton had driven to around the Cape 25 on one of their earlier possessions in the ballgame. That's been the deepest penetration. Edwards looking to throw. He's under pressure in traffic. He's wrapped up and dragged down. Back at about the 25. Ironton moving from their own 27 late here in the first half. Spencer a wide out to the near side, Young to the far side. AJ running the football. He's across the 30 and forced out of bounds on the far sidelines right at about the 30. From Fighting Tigers, Vincent Clark awaiting that punt is back at about his 42, 43-yard line. So Ironton Steinert in the last couple of possessions. And Spencer on to kick the football away with just over 3 minutes to play in the first half. Here's the snap. And the kick by Spencer. It's another boomer. The kick, bouncing. Clark now is going to pick it up at his 31. Southers hitting him. And Clark getting away. He got away from Southers. He's at the 40. The 45. Clark is going to go all the way for the touchdown. Vincent Clark. 69-yard punt return. Southers had him wrapped up. And Clark kept driving the feet. Southers got a little bit of help, but it wasn't enough as Clark squirmed his way out of the initial hit and then had lots of room to run, and he returns at 69 yards for the touchdown. Ironton surrendering a touchdown on the punt return. It's 13-0. Cape on top of the Ironton Fighting Tigers with 2:46 to play in the first half. Tech game features some stellar prep players. Here's the kick by McFadden. It is through the uprights, to the left side, but through. 2:46 to play first half. It's Ironton trailing the Cape. It's Cape 14. Ironton nothing this half for the most part. Sitting back in its seats now, it's been the Vincent Clark show. He has put two touchdowns on the scoreboard at long distance variety. The latest, a 69-yard punt return. McFadden the extra point. And it's Cape 14, Ironton nothing, with 2:46 to play in the first half. And the Cape kickoff coming up. Lewis and Bryce are deep for the Fighting Tigers, back at about their six. Here is the kick, scribbling along the ground. Jackson picks it up. Willie Jackson ahead with the football. He returns it back to about the 41-yard line, where he's brought down there. And Ironton has about 2.5 minutes to play here in this first half to do something about trailing in the ball game. 14 to nothing. Bryce started to come to the near side as the wideout. Now he's reversing himself and going to the far side as the flanker on first and 10. A.J. Edwards, he's looking to throw. He's under pressure. Penalty flags on the play, and Edwards bottled up and dropped back at about his 36. The Cape defense, again, quickly closing in and not affording Edwards the opportunity to do that broken field running and broken play running that has been such a beneficiary for the Ironton offense. For sure put some points on the board going into the locker room at halftime and get momentum swinging back in their favor. It is first down and 25. 15-yard penalty assessed against the Fighting Tigers. The line of scrimmage now, the 26-yard line of Ironton. Edwards under center. He's looking to throw. He's got the protection. He cranks it up. Bobby Bryce is out there. Bryce cannot make the reception. Clark there defensively. Also with him running step for step is Ricky Reed. They have double coverage on Bobby Bryce as Ironton goes for the home run down the far sideline in front of the covered portion of the stadium. They're missing connections. Minute 58 to play in the first half. The clock stopping with the pass incompletion. It goes in motion with the snap of the ball. A.J. Edwards back to throw. Rolling, he's under pressure. Pass over the middle, nearly picked off. Darnell Lee saying he has the interception at the 40, but the officials say incomplete. Joe Young, the intended receiver, with a minute 52 showing on the clock in the first half, and Ironton not only wanting to convert this big third down play here, but they certainly don't want to give Cape another opportunity with the football here in the first half. Edwards looking to throw, pass over the middle, batted up in the air, and Darnell Lee makes the interception. It bounced off the fingertips of James Lewis, went high in the air. Darnell Lee made the interception, and Lewis is still down about the 37. But what Lee was denied on the play before, he comes back and makes here. And James Lewis down on the field at about the 39, so he's got a timeout. Timeout in the first half. The score, Cape 14, Ironton nothing. James being helped to his feet and will be assisted to the sideline now by a couple of the Ironton ball players and members of the Ironton coaching staff. But Cape gets the football back with a minute 45 to play in the first half, already leading 14 to nothing. And pretty much on a defensive roll as they've really shut down Ironton on offense. And now with excellent field position, something to say about increasing this 14-0 score. But then again, the Fighting Tiger defense may have an answer for that. Clark in the slot to the right side. He scored both of Cape's touchdowns tonight. Lee pitching. Snow down the sideline, driven out of bounds. Man to the right. Houston, the flanker to the right. Hand off Snow. He's hit and wrapped up by Matt Thomas. Right at about the line of scrimmage. A good penetration by the junior defensive tackle and making a stop on Thomas, or Snow. And Cape in a hurry up offense now on third down, third and four. Darnell Lee rolling to his right. Still looking under pursuit by Southers. Gets away from him. Now puts the football up. And it's picked off by Bobby Bryce. Bobby Bryce the football. He puts a move on. Come on, Bobby. At the 40. Puts the head down, and he's across the 45 to about the 47-yard line. So Bryce, the intercept, and he's brought down by Bryant, the fullback, trailing the play. The Tigers get the ball back with 55 seconds to play in the first half. Big play, Steve.
Big play. Bobby Bryce playing like a deep safety, like a center fielder in baseball. He was there, put a real good move around the 20-yard line, and found out that the pursuit lanes were coming in on him. He put his head down, and a big play for the Tigers. That was a very, very big play because Cape was driving down the field. So let's see what the Tigers can do with 49 seconds to go here in the second quarter play.
Very similar to the interception that Lewis made against Greenham County a week ago. Again, the Tiger defense forcing the quarterback to the sideline in that particular situation. Same thing happening here. Lee rolling towards the sideline right in front of the Ironton bench before he unloaded the football, fed it back the other way. And Bryce made the pickoff and returned back to the 46-yard line. Ironton offense moved the ball downfield, put some points on the board, and in this first half on an up note for the Fighting Tigers. Double wideouts to the far side. Edwards under pressure. Edwards putting the football up. It's caught by Spencer. Charlie away. Midfield. 45. 40. Head down. He's inside the 40 and down at about the 37-yard line. Charlie Spencer, the reception. He got away from a jersey tackle at midfield. And he has a first down in Cape territory. They mark it at the Cape 36. There are 34 seconds left in the first half. So a big play there. Charlie Spencer getting his hands on the football. He lets the big rush come in. And Edwards looping the pass over that rush. Got the ball to Spencer.
Tigers well covered. That time he found Spencer, hit a secondary receiver. Resulted in the first down of a big game for the Tigers.
Again, double wideouts to the far side. Looking pass over the middle intended for Bryson. He can't make the reception. Bobby trying to catch the ball down around his knees at about the 30, and it fell incomplete. So the clock only moving 3 seconds, and it'll be second down and 10 for Ironton.
Look for the same type of play on this particular play also, Rick. They're throwing underneath the coverage because their D-backs are really have blessed with a lot of speed and are covering the wide receivers of the Tigers very well.
Again, double wideouts to the far side. Spencer in the slot. Edwards back to throw. He's got the protection. He puts the football up. Bryce is up there. He gets inside the 10 at the 8-yard line. Bobby Bryce, a diving catch. Sprinting on a post pattern towards the pylon, marking the end zone for the touchdown, but he stopped at the 9-yard line, and there are 25 seconds left in the first half.
What a catch by Bobby Bryce. We've seen it happen many times in this 86 football season. And again, I'll say, what a pass by A.J. Edwards. He had plenty of time to throw that particular time. He just went out in a vertical jump, leap, got the football. It was unbelievable. It was just a great catch. He hit the ground. He got over the football. And now the Tigers have a real threat to the Cape Crusader defense.
With a first and goal to go from the 9-yard line. There are 25 seconds left in the first half. It's Cape 14, Ironton nothing, but the Fighting Tigers a golden opportunity awaiting them just 9 yards away to put some points in, as we've been saying, trying to go to the locker room on a very, very much upbeat note. Spencer, wide out to the near side. Young to the far side. He'll have Bryce in the slot. Lewis and Malone, the setbacks behind A.J. Edwards. A.J. looking to throw, looking for the slant, and pass out far side, touchdown, Bobby Bryce! Bobby Bryce finishes off what he started a play ago, lifting out to the left flat, and he makes the touchdown reception in the end zone, with 20 seconds to play in the first half. Some kind of comeback for the Fighting Tigers. And Bobby Bryce just about solely responsible for that. With a fine interception return, the big pass reception down inside the 10, and the touchdown reception to finish it off. Spencer on for the extra point. Here's the snap, the spot, the kick. It's dead on center. It is now Cape 14, Ironton 7. We'll keep it here again, engineer. We'll catch up on our spots at halftime. Got penalty flags, and that's another good reason to keep it here. We got penalty flags down right at about the 10. And let's see. Holding indicated against the Cape, and they could exercise the penalty on the kickoff. Added on to where Ison kicks off, and they kick off from the Cape 45-yard line.
And again, a big weapon for the Tigers this particular time. A.J. has a strong foot, but you might as well figure it. This one's going to go almost into the Ison swimming pool because they do not want Mr. Snow or Clark or anybody to get their hands on the football with 20 seconds to go. Snow can go down the field in about 10 seconds or less. And what they're going to be doing right now, I'm sure, is just kicking it out of the end zone. Let them take it over to the 20-yard line. Great football game here tonight, folks.
Fighting Tigers coming to life inside. Had 43 seconds to move the football upfield, and that they did. 14-7, Cape on top with 20 seconds to go in an excitement-filled first half. Here's the approach by Edwards. And the kick to the far side. Fielded at about the two. Bobbles the football. Under pressure, and he's down. He's down inside the five at about the three. Tate recovering the football. As the man trying to make the return there is David Mathis, and he had it knuckled away from him after he touched it.
Jason Ferguson was the first man down to lay the hit on him.
So there are 17 seconds left in the first half. And Cape, with their very backs to the wall, the clock will start to roll. And Cape is going to finish the first half in very precarious position. Darnell Lee, quarterback keeper, and he's down at about the five. And that takes care of the first half of play. Super football game here at Tanks Memorial Stadium tonight. It is halftime. And our score is the team's head to the locker room. The Cincinnati Academy of Physical Education, 14. The Ironton Fighting Tigers, 7.
So, and the extra point by McFadden made it 7-0 with 11:04 in the second quarter of play. It stayed that way until a 61-yard punt return with 2:46 seconds to go in the second quarter of play from Benny Clark, 61-yard touchdown punt return there. And then with 20 seconds to go in the contest, in the first half of play, Edwards hit Bryce on a 46-yard strike to inside the 5-yard line or inside the 10-yard line. In the next play, a strike to Edwards, to Bryce, made it 14-6, and Charlie Spencer went in for the extra point, the kick, and made it 14-7. That's where we stand here at halftime. The Ironton Fighting Tigers will be receiving the football this particular second half of play. They'll be going right to left of your radio dial, dressed in their traditional home black uniforms. As we start this second half of action between the number one and number two rated football teams in the state of Ohio, AA. Carlos Snow will be going to kick it off for Cape. Back deep for the Tigers. We see Junie DePriest and Bobby Bryce. DePriest gets the ball at his 10-yard line. He's up to the 30-yard line. Past the 30. Still on his feet. Rolls to the 34 before he is smothered there by Cape. So Junie DePriest gets a nice run back at some 20 yards on that particular kickoff return, and we start the Tigers of Ironton from their own 34-yard line. The other end, quarterback A.J. Edwards, Lewis, Malone, and Spencer in an I formation. Slot to the left is Spencer. Edwards keeps the ball on his left side, and he maybe gets one on the play before he's stopped there by Dudley. As the Tigers break huddle, Edwards behind the center. I formation, Malone and Lewis in the backfield. Out wide to the left is Bobby Bryce. A reverse to Bobby Bryce. Bobby trying to throw it. Now he's going to throw long. He's looking for Spencer. Spencer almost intercepted down to the 25-yard line. A little reverse play that didn't develop real well as Edwards had trouble taking his hand off to Malone, and he pitched it back to Bryce, and Bryce has a strong arm. We've seen it earlier this year, but he underthrew Spencer. Spencer had his man beat by maybe a step or two. Third down and 9 for the Tigers. I formation, slot to the right of Spencer. Edwards going back to fast being pressured, throws downfield. Tips Young at the 40-yard line, down to the 45, and rolls to the 40-yard line. Make it the 42, it'll be first down and 10 for the Tigers. Nice pass, a nice catch over the middle by Young. Some big defenders back there for Cape, and Young, one of the smallest players, if not the smallest player on the Tiger squad, besides James Lewis, and showed that he had courage going across the middle. A nice pass play from A.J. Edwards. It's first down and 10 for the Tigers, invading Crusader territory for the first time this half. 22-yard pickup on that pass play. 43, they mark it on the 43-yard line in Cape territory. Here come the Tigers. High formation. Edwards hands off to Lewis, goes right side. Lewis scampers around and finally gets dragged down. And a nice play by Cape to go in this third quarter of play from Ironton Tank Stadium. Cape on top, 14-7. Tigers once again coming out. Edwards behind the center. We have somebody jumping for Cape, and it's going to be a 5-yard penalty against the Crusaders. Unless someone pulled them off sides, they did not. It's 5 yards assessed to the Cape Crusaders. In. Let's see who took Lewis's place. It's Malone. Bryce is playing the tailback position for the Tigers. First time we've seen that this year, I believe. Bryce getting the ball to the right side. Bryce makes a tackle. He gets inside. Bryce to the 10. He's going for a touchdown. No flag. It's a touchdown, Tigers. 1986 season. Bobby Price goes almost untouched for a touchdown, 34 yards. And just like that, it's 14-13. Cape on top. Forgive me if I got a little excited. It was a thing of beauty again. Great blocking on the right side. Bryce went to his right, cut to his left, and went in there untouched for a touchdown. And Charlie Spencer attempting the all-important extra point. The snap, the kick is up, and the kick is good. We are deadlocked between the number one and number two rated teams in the state of Ohio at Tank Stadium. It's 14-14.
We're trying to close in on him. DePriest got picked off on a good block, and I think the clip was against Jackson because he went down pretty hard right there, right about the area. I didn't actually see the clip, but I saw a Tiger ball player, I believe was Jackson, go down pretty hard right there, right in the vicinity where the flag was thrown. So they do get a break there. Lots of times you see something like that happen, a touchdown run to go ahead and carry it out. But a big, big break for the Tigers, and now momentum definitely has shifted in favor of the home team.
A big play for the Tigers as Snow broke loose in the open. He did step out of bounds around the 48-yard line, but he kept running, and the Tigers kept chasing, and it is very difficult, if not sometimes impossible, to catch the man. We do have a timeout now, some sort of discussion between Benny Clark and one of the coaches, and it looks like Edwin Houston failed to come into the contest, and the coach is screaming at him. So any way you look at it, it'll be a first down and 10. It's kind of a scary situation there for the Tigers of Ironton. The Tigers are fired up. The ball is marked inside the 10-yard line in Cape territory. We'll call it the 8-yard line. The quarterback, eye formation. Ironton going to the six-man front. Kind of an odd formation. There's the handoff to the fullback, Bryant. Bryant doesn't get anything, maybe a couple. He goes off the left side as Ironton using different defensive formations. We've talked about Coach Bob Lutz, how he likes to mix things up, especially against good football teams. Now the third quarter for the Ironton Tigers, generally a good scoring and good defensive quarter for the Tigers because Coach Lutz and his coaching staff gets the young man in at halftime and talks to him. Tell him what's going on. We'll see what prevails here. Here comes Cape Snow, the lone set back in the backfield, making an eye formation with Bryant. Lee, the quarterback, pitches out to Snow around the right side. Snow going to the left. Gets a block. Look out. Snow is on the loose. Snow gets dragged out from behind by number 51 for the Tigers. That is John Thompson.
Lewis, great speed. Lewis is limping off the far sideline.
Bobby Bryce coming in. Eye formation again. Cape with the ball at their own 20. Hand off to the first back three. That's Bryant. Bryant is on the loose. Bryant still on his feet. Crosses the 50-yard line before he is tackled there. And it'll be another first down. As the Tigers... Mike Southers finally caught Bryant. Bryant has some pretty good speed, too, and he showed it there. Ball is in Ironton territory, the 48. Doing nothing fancy, just running straight off tackle. Lee rolling back to pass. Is he going to pass? He's looking for somebody to throw the ball to. He throws the ball, and the ball is picked off. Edwards has got it. Edwards still on his feet. And he finally brought down at the 39-yard line. So Lee overthrows his intended receiver. And a big break for the Ironton Tigers as A.J. Edwards picked the ball off at the right place at the right time, playing his zone coverage. And Edwards gives the Tigers of Ironton the football. One way to keep Cape from scoring is to hold the football. The Tigers are going to be trying to do that right now. 7:56, the clock is running. In the third quarter of play, it's 14-14.
Great pressure by Southers and Thomas, and Southers got right up in the face of Lee there before he unleashed the football.
A again, the Tigers out. Bobby Bryce playing the tailback position. Edwards behind the center. Hand off to Bryce off the right tackle. Just this time, Bryce still on his feet. Crosses the 40 up to the 43. Hurry is stopped there by a Kate Crusade. The quarter of play in at Dandy at Tank Stadium. Full house back to formation. Junior DePriest in the contest for the Tigers. Edwards hands off to his first man. Dumel keeps the ball. Going on the right side. Edwards still on his feet. Crosses the 50. Down to the 45 in Cape territory. It's another first down for the Ironton Tigers, and things are starting to look exceptionally well for the Tigers. First down and 10. AJ fooled a lot of people, including yours truly here, with a fake to Malone on the right side. Kept the ball. Went around his right side and scampered enough for first down yardage. The ball is marked on the 45-yard line in Cape territory. 6:55 to go. We are deadlocked at 14-14 here at Tank Stadium. John Thompson, the center, coming out, breaking huddle. Malone, Rice, and Spencer in the backfield. Edwards behind the center. We're going to have offside against the Cape Crusaders. So that'll bring up a 5-yard penalty against Cape. And it'll bring up a first down and 5. And most importantly, it gets the ball down to the 40-yard line in Cape territory. Number 78, Matt Thomas, comes into the contest, replacing McClellan. The Ironton line starting to dominate somewhat here in this third quarter of play. John Thompson, the center, brings the Tigers out again. Malone, Spencer, and Bryce in the backfield. Ends are in tight. Hand off to Edwards, keeps the ball going around the right side, maybe gets one. They fake the Bryce that time off the right. A.J. kept the ball, good pursuit by Kate. And maybe a gain of one on the play. It'll bring up a second down and five situation. So he didn't get anything. 14-14, Kate, Ironton, 1-2. Full house backfield formation. Edwards behind the center, Thompson. Long count. Hands off to Malone. Malone pulls off the right side and up for a first down. Over the 35, down to the 34-yard line. First down and 10 for the Tigers. And the Tigers apparently have found a weakness at halftime on the left side of the Cape Crusader line, because they have been going to their right virtually all this second half of play. And the third quarter goes out. Billy Jackson in at a tight end. Ironton again in the full house backfield formation. Edwards hands off to Malone. Malone going to the left side. Jumps over one tackler and gets met by a couple of others. Maybe a gain of two on the play. We'll see. Here come the Tigers breaking the huddle against the very tough Cape defensive team. Full house backfield formation. Edwards rolls out the pass, looking downfield, now being pressured, still looking downfield, throws downfield over to DePriest's head. DePriest is open, but give credit where credit's due. Kate put a lot of pressure on A.J. and really disoriented the play as far as the Tigers were concerned. A.J. had to roll to his left and throw across his body to the right. That's right, third pass. Okay, now we're going to have a timeout called right now. Timeout, Ironton. Our score with 5:03 to go in the third period of play is 14-14.
Your attention, please. The lucky number for the home security package, donated by your State Farm agents, Willard Dale.
Back at Ironton's Tank Memorial Stadium, a 14-14 deadlock between the number one and number two ranked teams in AA football in the state of Ohio. Cape number one, Ironton number two, with 5:03 to play in the third period. Just about everything you can hope for and ask for out of a high school football game, and really any level of football. The excitement pitch keeps building. It seems to rise and fall with every snap of the football, and a third period here in which the momentum seemingly has shifted in favor of the Ironton Fighting Tigers. The first half, and they've scored here in the second half to tie it up. We're back to action.
Third down and 8. High formation. Edwards rolls back the pass. Looks, throws, hits Bryson out of his hands. Bobby wanted to run with the football before he caught it. And good coverage there by Cape here in this third quarter of play. Lot to the right is Bryce, I formation. Edwards rolling back the pass, looking downfield. Now runs the ball, still on his feet. Down to the 30-yard line. Did he make it for first down? Let's see. I think he may have. I'm not sure.
Oh, yeah.
Looks like it's going to be enough for a first down. We'll see.
2 yards.
It's going to be a first down. Edwards, pardon me for getting tongue-tied there. I thought he had thrown the football. Why, I don't know. Tigers of Ironton with a first down and 10. The ball inside the 25-yard line. We'll call it the 23. Full house backfield formation. Malone's got the football. Malone to the left side. Malone to the 10. He's inside the 10-yard line. It's Archie in zone Malone. Smell Pedro that time. Come up about 9 yards short. Went off a trap play, it looked like, up the middle. Good blocking for the Tiger offensive line. And it'll be first and goal for the Ironton Tigers. In with the play comes Billy Jackson. The ball is marked at the 6. They'll make that 6 first down for the Tigers. The ball is on the 8-yard line, but 6 first downs for the Tigers in a time-consuming and hopefully scoring play for the Tigers of Ironton. Full house backfield formation once again. Malone with the football. Malone rolls close to the 5-yard line before he's stacked there by Dudley. Also in the play is Sean Stevens, number 64, 5'8", 165-pound junior.
Ironton's missing one of their weapons. James Lewis continues to miss from the lineup. Junie DePriest is in there for him. And James went hobbling over to the sideline the last particular series Ironton had the football. So he's missing, but DePriest providing that relief from the bench. He's doing a job.
Joe Young into the contest. Junie DePriest as one of the halfbacks. He's playing left halfback. It's second down and 5. Second and goal for the Tigers, and Kate jumps again. A mistake being costly from the Crusaders. That time, number 82 for Kate goes offside. That'll be Chip Wilson. So now it'll make it the second down and 3. The ball is marked half the distance to the goal. Second down and 3. Who do you look for here? Well, I can give you a big hint. He wears number 37. I expect him to be in at least one time on the right side. We'll see. We don't care who it is. Just get in the end zone. Second down and 3. Full house backfield formation. Malone to the right side. Malone rolls down close to the 1. Before he stopped, that'll bring up a third down. We'll call it probably third down and 1 on the left end position. Big play, third down and 1. The Tigers knocking on the door in Cape territory. Third down and goal. Malone with the football. Malone bulls his way. He does not make it in. Nice tackle there by Cape as he's met by about 3 or 4 Cape Crusaders. Led by number 3, Melvin Ellis. And that'll bring up a fourth down and 1. Let's see, Rick, can they get a first down without scoring? I don't think so.
Started from the 9. Started the series from the 9.
So they have to be in the end zone. The ball is just short of the goal line. And we're going to have a timeout on the play right now. Timeout, I believe, Ironton. I'm not sure. But we will tell you this, that it's 2:25 to go in this third quarter of play. And the score is tied 14-14 this game. In the tri-state, it's raining, and the Tigers are 1 yard away from a touchdown to break this 14-14 tie. Full house back to the formation. Fourth down, Edwards, and yeah! Archie Malone goes off the right side for a touchdown, and the Tigers of Ironton take the lead, and the Crusaders at Cape look a little stunned. Town is going crazy across the way. A sea of orange along with rain falling. And thank goodness we haven't seen much snowfall tonight. I had to say it. 20-14 in favor of the Tigers and the all-important extra point kick by Charlie Spencer. The snap, the kick is up, and it is good. The Ironton Tigers with 2:22 to go, thanks to a 1-yard run by Archie Malone, take a 21-14 lead, and more importantly, really ate up the clock. We will keep it right here. The momentum is here for the Ironton Tigers. Now it's up to the defense, which has played fairly well in this third quarter of play, but the offense has kept Crusaders offense from even being on the field. Now, here's an important situation. The Tigers of Ironton will be kicking off. Edwards, and back deep is the ever-dangerous All-American number 25, Carlos Snow. I'm sure Coach Lutz and Mike Burchett and the rest of the Tiger coaches would like to see the ball kicked to the other back, which is, I believe, number 40.
Mathis. David Mathis.
So we'll see. This is important. The kickoff. AJ needs to get a dandy, or at least kick it away from Carlos Snow. It's 21-14 in favor of the Ironton Tigers. 2:22 to go. And Edwards gets the go-ahead from the referee. And here we approach the football. He does. He kicks it over to the left side. That's Mathis. Mathis. The ball is rolling out. And it's going to be a penalty against the Tigers. He did it right. It rolled out. Plenty of football to play here at Tank Stadium. The number one and number two rated teams in the state of Ohio doing battle. And believe me, words can't describe what a good contest it's been this far. Through three and three quarters of football. Two and three quarters of football. Look out. Carlos Snow is going to be taking it at his 10-yard line. He fumbles the ball. He goes around the side, up the middle. Look out. Carlos Snow on his feet. He's over the 40-yard line, and he's still on his feet to the 37. Excuse me. Well, I tell you, it is scary when that young man gets the ball. He dropped the ball around the 10-yard line, went up the middle, across the 20 to the 25 to the 30, and over the 35. They're marking the ball at the 38-yard line in Cape territory, and that is a little scary. 2:10 to go in the third quarter of play. Here comes Cape. High formation. Lee, Bryant, and Snow in the backfield. The ball is handed off to Carlos Snow. Snow gets tackled by Billy Jackson. We have another penalty on the play. He goes over the 40-yard line and close to a first down, maybe a couple of yards short. We'll see. What's the penalty? Preliminary indication. Looks like it's going to be holding against Tate. To me, like the left tackle, number 77 for Cape. Two receivers, including Ben and Clark. Snow is in motion. Lee goes up the middle. Lee still on his feet and smothered by Summers and Thompson. And he gets nowhere. A loss on the play. Back inside the 25. See where they mark the football. It's forward progress. He's down a little bit, getting up slow. He's had a rough night tonight, but giving credit. He's not a real big football player, but he is exceptionally quick and does a good job of running the football. Formation for Cape Lee behind the center. Bryant and Snow in the eye. Pitch out to Snow, coming on this side. Snow gets it loose over the 40-yard line, still on his feet. And he is hit by Young and Edwards. So Carlos, I'm telling you, the man is a specimen as far as running the football. Doesn't look like he's that quick. He is. Doesn't look like he's that strong. He is. Down and nine with 50 seconds to go in the third quarter. Cape with the football. I formation. Lee rolls back the pass. Pitches out to Clark. Little pitch back. Clark's doing his feet, and he is going to be smothered by Spencer. And we have a little altercation on the sidelines as Clark didn't like it, but a great defensive play.
Carney.
By Carney, and I believe Spencer also on the play. Didn't pull him a bit. They had a little inside reverse, little double pass to the right. That'll bring up a fourth down and nine, and it looks like they will have to punt. And the Tiger town across the way, the Ironton Tiger faithful across the way, giving the Tiger defense a standing ovation. Deep for the Ironton Tigers, Joe Young. Normally James Lewis would be there. Or Bobby Bryce, number 24, standing back at their own 30-yard line. 9 seconds, 8 seconds to go in the third quarter of play. 6 seconds. Snap is good. The punt, a spiral. It's going to be taken by Young, though he's going to let it loose. He gets away from it. Down to the 15-yard line. Nice punt. And down inside the 15. So the Tigers will take over. That's the end of the third quarter of play. And a dandy one it was. Our score, the Ironton High School 21 and Cape 14.
AJ Edwards keeps it on the ground. This is Bobby Bryce around the left side. Bryce across the 15. He's out near the 20. That's picked up close to 6 yards. So the Fighting Tigers, a 14-point third quarter to overtake the Cincinnati Academy of Physical Education. And we can pretty much safely surmise it's the first time this season that Cape has trailed in a ball game. So earlier when Cape was on top, it was the first time Ironton was down.
Exactly. They have been beating teams averaging some 40-some points a ball game. And I'm sure they expected a tough contest, but maybe not this tough. They come into Tank Stadium. The Ironton Tigers looking exceptionally well so far here in this second half of play.
Light rain continues to fall. Ironton with the second down from their 20. Call it second and four. Edwards under center. Long count. And penalty flag. Not so good. That should be a delay of game against Ironton, and will just about all but wipe out the first down carry by Bryce. Pretty much the same for the most part down to our right. Second down for the Tigers. Archie Malone straight ahead with the football. He's across the 15 to about the 17 before he's brought down there. Third down play. Third and six for the Tigers from their 17. Over the middle. It's caught by Young. He's down at about the 25. That's close to the first down. Boy, super catch by Joe Young. That's the second time tonight we've seen the little man make the reception coming across the middle. The Cape defense converging on him, and Joe took a pretty good hit. And it is a Tiger first down. That's a big reception by Joe Young. And he's coming out and gets a fine round of applause and is replaced by Barry Carney. He earlier caught a 22-yard pass that aided the Tigers in that scoring drive they put together here in the third quarter to tie the game up. First and 10 Tigers from their 25 from the straight tee. Edwards keeping it on the ground. Malone cracks across the 25 to perhaps the 26, as are the Cape Crusaders. To the straight tee again. Edwards left side. A.J., perhaps a half-yard gain, maybe a yard gain, so that would move it to the 27. It'll be third down and a long eight for the Tigers from there. The game. A.J. Edwards, he's dropping back to pass. He's looking to throw. Puts the football up, but it's picked off. At the 38-yard line of Ironton, making the interception and diving to do so is Anthony Harris. So Cape gets a big shot there on as they steal away an A.J. Edwards pass on third down and have it first and 10 in Tiger territory. Certainly like to say hello to all of our friends in the Gallipolis and Point Pleasant area who just joined us on WYPC-FM in Gallipolis. Bill Gray and his fine staff up there. We're picking up the continuity of this ball game here. Cape the football in Tiger territory. Hand off Carlos Snow, and he's hit and dropped at about the 36-yard line. So for you folks who are here, we got a penalty flag. A late penalty flag back at the Ironton 21 after the play had finished. Personal foul, so unsportsmanlike conduct penalty coming up against Cape. Major step off against Cape, and it moves the football back into Crusader territory, back to the Cincinnati 49. About 100 yards rushing in the contest, but Ironton the leader by 7. The Cape with the football on a second down long yardage play. Lee, bootlegging. Coming his way, Southers wraps him up and drops him, but not before he gets to the Ironton 46. Snow and Bryant in the backfield. Bryant the fullback, Snow the tailback. Lee looking to throw, still looking. Football up, it's over the head of Clark and incomplete. Defensive coverage there by Joe Young. And Darnell Lee, the Cape quarterback, apparently took a pretty good lick at the end of that play because he's down and rising back in his own 48.
Most certainly did Mike Southers and also John Turner in on the play. And he has been shaken up. Every time he touches the football, he has been hit hard. But as we said earlier, a great competitor is Lee. He's one of the smallest Cape Crusaders. He's coming off the field right now. Big play for the Ironton Tigers. What does Cape do? They're down 4th and 18 with 7:39 to go in the fourth quarter of play. Let's see if they're going to punt. They do. Looks like they're sitting their punter in right now.
Bryant will be in to apparently kick the football away, although we see Carlos Snow coming here to the near side as a wideout. Danny Webb is there defensively for Ironton on that side. Has to be mindful of Snow's presence in the lineup. Here is the snap, but Bryant is going to kick the football away. It is a long, deep kick battling into the end zone. It will be a touchback. Ironton will have it first and 10 at their own 20. Battle of unbeatens, number one against number two, and it's a dandy. Bryce the football. Bobby hurdling tacklers, and he's across the 25 to perhaps the 26. You people listening in Gallup Police, former SEAL foes, Ironton and Gallup Police, both enjoying excellent seasons and both anticipating playoff action. And here you have a playoff-type atmosphere between Cape and Ironton. Bryce, Jay Edwards, the quarterback. He's got Malone, Spencer, and Bryce in the backfield with him. Bobby gets the call. Bobby is hit and wrapped up right at about that line of scrimmage. Tigers lead 21-14. A.J. Edwards, bootlegging left side. A.J. trying to get away from Clark, and he can't do it, but he's got the first down. Edwards out to the 39, and his crowd comes to life again. And Mark Dudley, the leading tackler and linebacker for the Cape Crusaders, just beside himself, I'm guessing because he's Jay, slipped one tackler, went around the left side right in front of the Tiger bench, whether it was roughing Edwards, maybe after face masking. Okay, that's the way that Edwards went down. He went down in an awkward way in front of the Tiger bench. Ironton spurred by the big carry by Edwards and the penalty, have it first and 10 at the Cape 45. On the ground, Archie Malone. Archie busting it down near the 40-yard line. Malone, stocky built fullback, the leading scorer for the Fighting Tigers. Here picking up 4 yards on the first down carry. Will make it second and 6. We are now approaching the 5:45 mark, and the clock's rolling in the ballgame. Ironton continuing to lead 21-14. A win by the Fighting Tigers virtually assures them of a first-place finish in Region 11 of Division 3 football. And whoever wins this contest gets a whole mess of points in the computer ranking system for playoff consideration. Cape is in Region 12 of Division 3 football. They trailed Wheelersburg this week. Straight tee. On the ground, Malone finds the going a little tougher this time, and he's bottled up right again at about the line of scrimmage. So again, Ironton must convert a third down play, but this time they'll be doing it in Cape territory.
Look what they seem to be doing, the Ironton Tigers, just basically fundamental football, going up the middle, going to the left side. Look, sometime, maybe not right now, but it looks like they're bringing the Cape secondary quarterbacks in a little bit. Maybe look for a little pass over the middle to one of the guys. They're stacking up on the right side. They seem to know that Ironton's going to be running the ball the left to right tackle. We'll see what happens on this particular play, but you can see that Clark and some of the other secondary are inside a little bit. We'll see what happens here.
Bryce checked in at the tailback position for Ironton, and he gets the call. Bobby's in heavy traffic and drilled as he crossed the 40 and stopped at about the 39-yard line. Bryce, who really started playing for Ironton little by little, piece by piece, week after week, with the second game of the season after moving here from Michigan and really getting a late start in the Tigers' practice regimen and training regimen, has been a central figure here tonight as he scored Ironton's first 2 touchdowns. And here got the third down carry and picked up a yard, so it's 4th down and 4 from the Cape 39-yard line. And this, to this point, I would venture to say the biggest play of the ball game, because we've got inside now 4 minutes to play in the contest. Fighting Tigers making sure they're getting everything right in the huddle. They're breaking the huddle now. A.J. Edwards, the senior quarterback, bringing him out. And we've got penalty flags, delay of game going up against the Fighting Tigers. 5 yards will be stepped off against Ironton, and I had mentioned that they were taking their time about asserting themselves, but now it looks like they were setting themselves up for the punt, which is exactly the case, because we see Mark Lips, the long snapper, and the rest of the punt team coming in. So Spencer will kick the football away.
I think that was a design play from head coach Bob Lips. It enables Spencer maybe a few more yards to maybe get it down deep in their end zone. Let's see what happens here.
Vincent Clark is not back very deep to receive the kick. Here is the kick by Spencer, and it's a high one. Clark signaling fair catch. It's going to bounce and roll on into the end zone. So Ironton didn't necessarily get the break, as the ball will come out first and 10 for Cape at their 20 following the touchback with 3:43 to play in the ball game. Rick Charles along with Steve James and a most exciting Ohio high school football contest. Darnell under center is Lee.
And they're going to the main man, Snow, with the football right side. He's hit and dropped it about the 25. Snow picking up five on the play. It'll be second down and five. So the man certainly with the ability to do damage from anywhere on the football field. A prime concern for the Fighting Tigers as we're at the 3:20 mark and the clock continuing to roll in the ball game. Ironton leading 21-14. It was 14-7 Cape at the half. Ironton overtook them in the third period, and that's where we stand now, 21-14 Tigers. Lee looking to throw. He's rolling, has the football up. Man's wide open out here in the flat. Makes the reception. That's Bryant. He loses his footing and falls back at the 36. And Joe Young just hit and had a push on it a little bit. Going to lose his footing. But Bryant drifted out into the flat to the left side. Was all by his lonesome. Made the reception. And Cape has picked up the first down. At their own 36. Lee connecting with his fullback. Carlos Snow gets the call. Turning to the outside. He's hit and driven out of bounds. Making a hit for Ironton was Joe Young and had a bit of a mismatch. Joe at 140 pounds. 49 showing on the scoreboard clock. Second down, four. Pitch right side. Carlos Snow. He's hit and dropped. John Thompson. Matt Thomas. At the bottom of the pile, Billy Jackson there defensively for the Fighting Tigers. No gain by Snow. It's third down and four, and this is a biggie. We're inside 2.5 minutes to play now in the game. A real nail-biter. Clark, the wing back to the near side. He scored both of Cape's touchdowns tonight. Darnell Lee under center. Makes the pitch. He's rolling to his right. Puts the football up, and it's caught. And the man appears to have the first down yardage by a couple of yards. And it looks like maybe a penalty flag in the area. No. Just the first down. Houston was just happy that they picked up the first down. Wilkins, Marcus Wilkins, was happy that Cape had picked up the first down, and they have it at the Cape 47.5-yard line, first and 10, so slowly but surely moving up the field. We are now inside 2 minutes to play in the contest. Lee looking to throw, looking for the quick out, pass out in the flat, it's incomplete. Clark, the intended receiver, had him working on Danny Webb, and Danny, Bryce, Edwards, Young, and Jackson comprising the Tigers secondary as they are anticipating Cape really to throw the football quite a bit now and work their two-minute drill to perfection. A minute 50 to play in the game. Pass incompletion stopping the clock. It's second down and 10, Cape from their own 47. Ryan at fullback, Snow at tailback. Lee under center with double wideouts. Again, looking to throw. Sutter's at him, and he got away. Lee looking to throw again. Puts the ball up, but it's incomplete. Webb made a diving attempt for the intercept, and Kelvin Ford belted Darnell Lee. And as Steve James has pointed out many times this evening, Lee is paying the price when he wants to throw the football. He towards the huddle and having a bit of an equipment problem. The Times have even scored on the 61-yard punt return and the 48-yard pass. The pursuit for the Tigers has been unbelievable. Snow has been getting his yards, but he can't not seem to break the long run. The pursuit for the Tigers. Let's knock on wood on that particular comment. It's third down and 10. This is a biggie here, too. Third and 10, Cape from their own 47. Lee back to throw again. The rush is on by Sutter. Well, dump pass and it's broken up by Kelvin Ford. And a penalty flag is going to call a late hit on the quarterback. Indication was a holding call. Quite understand that. I believe it was a late hit for it. They had Lee, and I believe they didn't know if he threw the ball or not, and they hit him after he threw the ball.
Boy, that is a big penalty. As I think it stopped him. And the aggressive play in their front line. Here's a step off. 5, 10, 15. That is better be a first down. A mighty, mighty big penalty. With a minute 41 to play in the game. Cape now in possession of the football at the Tiger 37. Darnell Lee in the huddle with his teammates, and they break that huddle now. And his crowd buzzing with anticipation for a slam-bang finish. Man of the slot to the left, that's Bryant. Lee looking to throw. He gets the pass off, and it is caught. Down at about the 22, a juggling catch by the receiver, Bryant. lined up in the slot to the near side, the left side, and made a juggling reception. He's down at the Tiger 22. That's another Cape first down, and we've got a minute and a half, minute 35 exactly, to play in the game. Ironton's 21-14 lead being threatened. So the last minute drive being put together by the Cape Crusaders. Darnell Lee under quarterback. He's got Bryant as fullback, Snow as tailback. Pitch, Snow, left side, Carlos driven out of bounds at about the 21-yard line. And trailing 21-14. Darnell Lee. Draw play, Carlos Snow up the middle, and he slips and falls at the 12. And there to make sure he stays down is Bobby Bryce. So the rain-soaked field here at Tanks Memorial Stadium, playing the part there, aiding and abetting the Tiger defense, and Snow is limping a bit as he comes off the field. Carlos shaking up and struggling to make it to the sideline, and now he is out of bounds. So he's out of the lineup. The Tigers getting a goal line of the there. And the clock is rolling. We'll be inside the minute mark when the snap of the football is conducted. Darnell Lee. Calling the signals. Left side, Bryant, hip wrapped up, trying to struggle forward to the 10, just barely made it, if he did make it. 48 seconds, 47, 46, 45. Now they stop the clock and a timeout. We're going to keep it right here. We'll keep it right here, given the moment and situation and what's at stake. Low Snow checking back in the Cape lineup with a slight limp. 45 seconds to go in the game. And the drama unfolding here at Tanks Memorial Stadium. A big penalty aiding and abetting this Cape drive as Ironton had apparently stopped Cape on a third down pass play, but Ironton was called for roughing the passer. A 15-yard step off gave Cape new life and the football in Ironton territory, and they've moved from there down to the Ironton 10. Second down, 8 for Cape from the Tiger 10. Carlos Snow is back in the lineup for Cape. Darnell Lee. Under pressure, Lee rolling to the right. He's looking, now puts the football up, and it's knocked out of bounds. Let's see, it's incomplete. Pass in the end zone, intended for Clark, and there to knock it away, I think, was Edwards. There are 37 seconds left in the game, and the clock stopping with the pass incompletion. And a penalty coming up? Yeah, penalty against Cape. Penalty flag is laying right at about the end zone, the goal line. And let's get the call. First we'll have a step off. There's 5, there's 10, there's 15 big yards, and you can hear the crowd roaring its approval in the background. Offensive pass interference is the call against Cape. And it moves the football back to the Tiger 25, where it's second down and 23. They lose the down two. That's right. That's right. It is third down and 23. On the offensive pass interference penalty, there's the loss of down as well as the yardage. Third and 23. 37 seconds to go. Cape from the Ironton 25. Lee looking to throw. Football up. It is overthrown. Pass intended on the far side for Edmonds Houston. And it's incomplete. We have 32 seconds to go. And a fourth down play coming up for Cape from the Ironton 25. Just maybe time enough to take about a half breath before the night's biggest play starts to unfold. Crowd pretty much all standing now. Look at them all across the way, everybody on their feet. Now we're going to have a full-fledged timeout by Ironton, but we'll keep it here.
We're not going anywhere.
Right 32 now, seconds to go in the game, and a fourth down, 23 coming up. Barn burner here at Tank Memorial Stadium.
For you, 32 seconds to go in the fourth quarter of play between the number one rated team in Ohio, the number two rated team in AA. Fourth down and 23.
Listen to the crowd. Crusaders. Darnell Lee is under center. He's got Snow in the backfield with him. Here's the snap. Lee looking to throw. Looking, looking. He's under pressure, and he's got it! He's got it! He's sacked him at the 35! He's sacked him at the 35, and the Ironton bench is going crazy. Yahoo! quarterback sack of Darnell Lee as he dropped him. Crashing in from his right defensive end, and it's the play of the game.
And let it be known that at 10:17 on this Friday evening at Ironton Tight Memorial Stadium, the Ironton High School Fighting Tigers will become the number one rated team in AA in the state of Ohio.
First time in history, and it feels good, it sounds good.
13 seconds to go, the clock is rolling.
Here's the countdown. Final score, the Ironton Fighting Tigers, 21, Cape 14, hold on everything. Paul, get him off the field. Hold on everything, we've got a penalty flag dropped right at the end of the game. A penalty flag dropped at the end of the game. And I think Ironton will be called for delay of game, perhaps. Let's see. Fans who had started streaming onto the field, the band, the ball players all being waved back off.
If Cape had the ball, it would be more critical, but Ironton has the ball right now.
Oh, yeah.
The victory is at hand. Tiger Town is celebrating tonight.
Boy, they did it to us last week. This big crowd now starting to file toward the exits, and they've seen just a classic Ohio high school football game here tonight. Here's the step off of the 5-yard penalty, but it's window dressing, and one that Ironton will readily accept. They come to the line of scrimmage. Edwards sets him down for the final snap, and that'll finish it. Now, it is final. The verdict is in. The Ironton Fighting Tigers, 21. The Cape Crusaders from the Cincinnati Academy of Physical Education, 14. A final from Tank Memorial Stadium. Number 2 has beaten number 1 in a heck of a football game.